It was exciting. It was just, we were glued to our TV sets. Of course,
Fred Hayes doesn't remember how old he was at the time, but the first U.S. landing on the moon was a day he'll never forget.
It was exciting, just sheer excitement. And this unmanned man is just continuing that.
This 81-year-old has stamps commemorating the Apollo landing more than 50 years ago.
Here we go. A lot of national pride. A lot of national pride. I mean, I have a degree in chemistry and physics, and I knew exactly what it entailed. It was a tremendous, a magnificent achievement.
Joe Silk is an astrophysicist at Johns Hopkins.
You know, it gave us something unimaginable to dream about. You know, this was an incredible step forward from the Earth, testing something totally new. And it was a dream at a time. We were fascinated by the astronauts taking their first steps on the moon.
For this new mission today, solar panels provide the spacecraft's power. The mission will last 7 days. Silk says this is the beginning of a new chapter in space travel.
We're building up to send humans back to the moon. And the first step will happen in 2 years' time. And one reason it's internationally so exciting is, quite apart from all the various commercial and other aspects of this, there's a competition between China and the US. Each is vying to get the first people back on the moon.